In the past, we've learned that when we're dealing with enzyme kinetics, we think about an enzyme binding to a substrate to form an enzyme-substrate complex, and that complex then being converted to enzyme and products. And we learned that we can determine some important kinetic parameters about this conversion of substrates to products using Michaelis-Menten kinetics, which allows us to experimentally determine a rate. And this equals Vmax times the concentration of substrate that gives us that rate divided by Km plus the concentration of substrate. And in this case, Vmax and Km are our two really important kinetic parameters that we can determine using the Michaelis-Menten model. But as it turns out, this Vmax value is really not very useful because it's dependent on how you set up the reaction. So how your reaction is set up. Because remember, we defined Vmax as K2 times the concentration of total enzyme. So this value of Vmax is dependent on how you set up the experiment because you set up how much enzyme is present. And if another scientist were to do this same experiment, they might come up with a different Vmax. So Vmax is not really useful to report. Instead, scientists have come up with a couple other really useful values that we're going to explore in this video. The first one is called the turnover number, okay? And we call this kcat. So the rate constant for catalysis, that's a K there. So this is the rate constant for catalysis. Okay, and kcat describes the conversion of our enzyme-substrate complex to enzyme plus products. So this is kcat. And as you'll note, this is the same as the second step in our enzyme kinetic model. So in the past, we've called this K2, but now this K2 we're calling kcat. So K2 equals kcat. Okay, so experimentally, this is easy to determine because using our Michaelis-Menten kinetics, we can determine Vmax. And we know that Vmax equals K2 or kcat times the total concentration of enzyme. So we can determine Vmax experimentally. We know the total enzyme concentration because that's how we set up the experiment. So kcat can be readily calculated by taking Vmax divided by the total concentration of your enzyme. Okay, so this is a first order rate constant. So this describes the conversion of enzyme substrate complex to enzyme plus products. So this is the first order conversion of our intermediate to our products. And therefore it'll have the units of usually seconds to the minus one, but time to the negative one. Okay? And what's really interesting about this is that this is the number of processes, the number of conversions that can happen in one unit of time. So the larger this number, the better the enzyme is at producing products. Okay, so the larger kcat, the more processes that happen in 1 second. And just to give you an idea of a typical range for enzymes, so usually the range of kcat is roughly 10 to the negative, or 10 to the third through 10 to the seventh, and this is per second. Okay, so this is a range of our kcat values you'll typically see. Just to compare, if we think about industrial processes, so chemical reactions that happen in industry, these turnover numbers tend to be in the range of 10 to the minus 2 up to about 10 to the third, right? So these are for an industrial process. These kcat values are for enzyme catalyzed reactions. So you can see that enzymes are much, much better at making products than what we can do in the laboratory without enzymes. So biological systems are much more advanced than what we've figured out to be able to do so far. Okay, so that's the turnover number. The other really important value that we can report as scientists is known as the catalytic efficiency. And the catalytic efficiency considers the conversion of So we start with our enzyme and our substrate and converting this to enzyme and products. So this is going to be, all right, so the rate of this reaction then is going to be equal to whatever this rate constant is, we'll just call it K here, K times the concentration of enzyme, concentration of substrate. So we would expect this rate constant to be second order because we have first power here and first power here. So the catalytic efficiency is this rate constant. So this rate constant is our catalytic efficiency. And we can very easily determine this by taking our K cat, which we just determined, divided by Km, which we determine in our experiment. So this gives us a second order rate constant that describes the complete conversion of substrates to products. So it includes the affinity of the enzyme for the substrate. So let's go ahead and see an example then. Okay, so let's say that experimentally, so in the lab, you go in and you do an experiment and you determine that Vmax for this enzyme is, let's say, 30,000, and the units are micromolar per second. And you've determined Km is equal to 10 micromolar. Okay, and this was done using a 100 nanomolar enzyme. Okay, so this is 0.1 micromolar, and this is our ETOT, so our total enzyme concentration. So from this information, we can determine both K-cat and our catalytic efficiency, K-cat over Km. K-cat is Vmax, which is 30,000. In this case, we have micromolar per second, divided by our enzyme concentration, which is 0.1 micromolar. So what we can see here is that the micromolars cancel out, and we are left with a K-cat, or a turnover number, of 3 times 10 to the fifth, and this is per second. Our catalytic efficiency, let's call this cat efficiency, is equal to K-cat over Km. So our K-cat is 3 times 10 to the fifth, this is per second, divided by Km, which is 10 micromolar. So when we calculate this out, we end up with 3 times 10 to the fourth, and now our unit is per micromolar per second. So we see here that this is the unit of a second order rate constant, right? Per concentration per time is the unit for a second order rate constant. So this is our second order rate constant describing the conversion of enzyme and substrate all the way to product.